Welcome all of you in today's session. Today's session is specifically important because if you try to see the number of days that is left for the exam for the next year, is the months are very few. So what I would say currently, the number of days that we have is around 7 months. Considering 27th of June is the prelims for 2021. Now, students always ask me, sir, what should be the strategy? Well, macro strategy will never change. But yes, based on the time, one need to, probably understand the limitations and accordingly plan the preparation. If you try to see, and if you ask me genuinely that can we crack prelims in 6 months? I say yes. And the reason why I'm telling why you can crack prelims in 6 months, even if you start from scratch, अगर आप जीरो से स्क्रैच से भी पढ़ाई स्टार्ट करते हैं सो यू नो अ बेसिक क्वेश्चन विच आई एम श्योर एवरीबडी मस्ट बी हैविंग इन देयर माइंड दैट कैन दे क्रैक प्रीलिम्स कैन दे गेट सिलेक्टेड एंड आई वुड से यस यू कैन गेट सिलेक्टेड यू कैन गेट पास द हर्डल ऑफ द एग्जामिनेशन एंड यू कैन गेट सिलेक्टेड एज वेल बट रिमेंबर फ्यू थिंग्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंटली that UPSC is a journey which requires you to understand the nuances of competition. Aapko competitions ke nuances samajhne honge. You need to understand your own limitation, the time limitation, and accordingly plan the effort. And why I'm saying this, because I cracked the prelims when I gave my first attempt. That was way back in 2010. I cracked the examination is in 2009. To be 10 was the interview. I cracked the examination in 4.5 months. I left my job in January, mid of January, and the prelims was on 31st of May. So practically there was 4.5 months left, and I was able to do that. So I believe that everybody can do that. And agar sab log kar sakte hain, so what should be the strategy and approach? And if you stick to the basic strategy approach, things will work. So let's understand agle 180 days, 7 months. I'm assuming that you're preparing, from mid of December. Se aap taiyari kar rahe ho, how will you crack the prelims? Now, the first thing I always say that you need to understand the syllabi of the examination. You need to understand the syllabus. One common mistake which most of the aspirants make, they don't understand the syllabus. They don't do their homework on the syllabus. I ask each one of you, have you read the syllabus? And if yes, how many times? Do you understand in the UPSC syllabus? If yes, tell me whether direct subsidy is a part of syllabus or not. Tell me. Now, when I say such word, which means it's not that you've read the syllabus, it means that every word of the syllabus, you should be able to identify whether that is the part of syllabus or not. अगर आपने न्यूज़पेपर ओपन किया एंड मोमेंट यू ओपन द न्यूज़पेपर और आपके सामने कोई आर्टिकल आता है आर्टिकल कम्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू एंड इफ यू यू नो रीड द आर्टिकल एंड यू नॉट एबल टू जज कि ये यूपीएससी के लिए इंपॉर्टेंट है या नहीं है दैट इज प्रिसाइसली बिकॉज प्रॉब्ली यू डोंट हैव द इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द यूपीएससी एंड मोस्टली इफ यू सी यूपीएससी का सिलेबस का इनको अच्छा अंडरस्टैंडिंग होता है दे आर एबल टू फिल्टर दैट दिस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ यूपीएससी सिलेबस और नॉट सो यू कैन इजिली फिल्टर what you need to study and what you don't need to study with just a basic effort and approach. Now, how will I go in the next 45 minutes? I'll be discussing about the strategy for preparation and 45 minutes. And after 45 minutes, I'll be, for the next 30 minutes, I'll be taking questions one to one. I'll unmute each one of you and I'll take questions from each one of you. So I need your cooperation, in the coming, 1 hour. And believe me, मैं आपके सारे doubts clear करूँगा and whatever your issues and doubts are, I'll take each one of them. Okay, so let's start the session. Now the first thing, as I mentioned, syllabus. Do you understand syllabus? Have you read the syllabus? If I ask something, if this is a part of syllabus, can you say yes or no? And if you reach that level, that is the first thing. Syllabus का एक copy करके get it printed at your study place, your works, your study station, and that should be the first thing. The second is that after syllabus ka understanding, we need to map all the subjects. What are the subjects that come in UPSC? Now, what is the requirement of UPSC? UPSC wants you to understand India. UPSC wants you to understand ethos of India. UPSC wants you to understand the dynamics of India. UPSC wants you to understand the economy of India, the history of India, the geography of India, the culture of India, the society of India, you know, the governance of India, how we have reached here. UPSC wants you to know what is going around your environment. UPSC wants you to understand ki aap kitna jante ho in sab cheezon ke bare mein. What is your opinion? Is it good? Is it bad? Is it positive? Is it negative? Can you be a problem solver? Tomorrow, you know, a lot of young IS officers, they got, you know, duties where they had to, you know, head the subdivisional areas, and they became SDM, subdivision magistrate. And they had to do this COVID-19, mapping. They had to do, you know, contract tracing. They had to do, you know, everything. And for that, they need to have the leadership quality. So UPSC wants you to know, wants to know from you, from its own side, that ki aapke andar leadership quality hai. Can you be a sir, you know, officer tomorrow, and can you serve in the right spirit? Because these questions need to be answered if you want to, want to prepare for the examination. So what I would suggest at this point of time, that you have to start mapping the, you know, syllabus, understand the syllabus, and start mapping with the syllabus. Then mapping se pehle hum log understand karenge what are the dynamic and static areas. Now UPSC has two major areas if I talk about syllabi. The first is the conventional area, and the second is the unconventional area. So I'll discuss about that. Then current affair, ek bahut bada area, a very dynamic area, an area which, you know, makes everybody, you know, fear, because it is a challenging area. So current affair, dynamic area, kaise cover kare? Then how do you apply the filtering process? Because when you live in a dynamic area, bahut sara information, facts, you know, newspaper ke through or from sources are coming to you. So the next question comes in that, can you develop your filtering process? उसको हम डिस्कस करेंगे. After that, you know कि क्या करना है, क्या पढ़ना है, क्या नहीं पढ़ना है, कैसे पढ़ना है. The next is we'll focus on the study schedule. Study schedule for 3+3 months. I'm talking about 3 months में आप क्या करो, फिर next 3 months आपको क्या करना चाहिए. I'm assuming that you just have 6 months time. If you think that you have 7 months time, good for you. एक महीना आप NCERT पढ़ के अपना basics को develop करो. After that, I'll be discussing about the importance of previous year preparation, previous year questions, and the general tips for preparation. So I want each one of your attention, and let's start with that. Now, before starting, you need to understand the CSE process. You need to understand UPSC's examination. UPSC, a CSE process is about knowing India. It's about awareness. आपको aware होना पड़ेगा जो भी चल रहा है आपके around. This is a highly diverse job, so diversity requires knowledge which comes from various sources. Okay, so that is the first thing that you need to. The second thing is that, why do you want to serve the country? You need to ask yourself. For me, serving the country is an opportunity to learn and grow. You know, you need to ask yourself ki aap service mein kyun jana chahte ho, because you want to do something for society. You want to do something for yourself. You want to do something. You want a good job with good security and income prospects. Well, आपको अपना रीजन ढूंढना पड़ेगा, व्हाई डू यू वांट टू गेट इनटू द सर्विसेज. माय वॉइस इज लेस गाइस, मेरा वॉइस कम है क्या? ओके, इंक्रीज द वॉइस नाउ. इज इट ओके प्रिया? फेयर एनफ. ओके, सो I'm sure you must be knowing about the pattern of examination. Now UPSC has three stages. One is the prelims examination, it is an MCQ based. Then you go for the mains examination, which is descriptive. Prelims, when you clear the prelims, you go for the mains examination, which is descriptive. You have to focus on the writing skill. And after that, you clear this and you reach the third stage, that is the interview, which is a personality test. Now prelims is a typical examination, the toughest part of the examination, precisely because prelims is highly dynamic, and also because you get maximum competition in prelims. Prelims mein competition zyada hota hai, unlike in mains you just have some 10,000-12,000 people giving. So prelims is MCQ based, and it is all GS is the key here. To aapka bahut acha GS pe command hona chahiye, and you need to have a good analytical ability. You need to have good, you know, understanding of basics of the subjects, whether it is economy or history or geography or culture or society. ठीक है. मेंस इज अबाउट गुड कम्युनिकेशन एंड राइटिंग स्किल. सो विल डिस्कस ईच वन ऑफ देम. लेट्स गो. नाउ दिस इज द मेंस पार्ट. यू मस्ट बी नोइंग द मेंस पार्ट. इन द मेंस वी हैव यू नो फोर पेपर्स एंड देन वी देयर इज एसे ऑल्सो. In the four papers, we have history, geography, society, governance, constitution, social justice, IR. Paper three is, of course, economics, security, disaster management. And paper four is ethics, integrity, and aptitude. So these are the four subjects which are there. Now, preparation jab start karo, always start with the main syllabus. Don't follow prelim syllabus. And why I'm saying that? That when you start with the main syllabus, which means actually agar aap main syllabus ko dekhte ho, the main syllabus subsumes the prelim syllabus. Yani main syllabus already consists of the prelim syllabus. Okay, so you should always start with a prelim syllabus. Sorry, main syllabus. To ye jo pura GS ka you know prelim syllabus hai, this is already there in the main syllabus. Already there in the main syllabus. Okay, so we need to focus on the main syllabus, and in the main syllabus, start first with areas common for prelims and mains. Okay, to aap start karo, but start with the areas common for prelims and mains. Okay, that is how it is. For example, in the beginning, you can leave paper four. Ethics ko mat padho, leave it for now. Start with paper one, paper two, and paper three. Okay, so that is how you start. Always start with the main syllabus, but areas which are common with prelims. Now you can see here. Then understand the weightage of the subjects. Weightage, very important. For example, in history you get around 15 to 18 questions every year. In polity you get around 12 to 15 questions every year. Economics again 15 to 18 questions every year. In geography, environment, total you get around 30-35 questions every year. Okay. In science and tech again 10 to 12 questions every year. In current affair, maybe remaining will go in the current affair. Now you try to see weightage. History mein kitna 15 to 18% weightage. Polity 15% weightage. Economics 18% weightage. Economics se current jod do, so this reaches around 25% of weightage. Geography environment very important. Together they can actually with adding with current affair they can be 40% of the syllabus. So you need to understand ki which subjects ka weight kya hai, and accordingly you need to prepare. Many times students make a mistake, and what they don't understand ki bhai many a times, for example, I'll give an example. In history, you have to read some 7 to 8 NCERTs and at least 2 standard books. Then you can clear this paper. Aap 15-18 question ko karne ke liye aap 7 to 8 NCERTs minimum and 2 standard books you have to do that. But if you go in polity, you just have to read maybe 2 NCERTs or 3 NCERTs plus 1 standard book. Which means you can cover polity in a lesser time. Same goes with economics. You have to read some 2 NCERTs, 2 to 3 NCERTs and 1 standard book. Aba aap dekho, when a student who is studying history and when you try to do your cost benefit analysis, what do you see here is that if I, the effort, you know, made by me in covering 2 subjects, polity and economy, is equivalent to polity plus economy. The effort is equal to history, which means in the same effort I can crack, you know, 30-35 questions, and history also, but in history I'll just get some 15 to 17 questions, which means I always advise student that start from subjects which has more weightage in the examination, because moment you cover the subject, it's not about covering the subject, it is about covering the requirement of the competition. So moment jise aapne polity economics complete kar liya, and moment you complete polity and economics with, this means that you are thorough with the 1/4 of the paper. Now try and understand, 1/4 of the paper is ready with just 2 subjects, and in just 2 months you can cover this. Okay, same, or 1.5 months, 45 days to 50 days, you can do that. Same is true, but in geography environment, but geography environment will same number of questions will require almost double the effort. आपको जितना effort economy polity में लग रहा है उसका double effort environment and geography में लगेगा. Why? Because environment geography is very wide in terms of syllabi. But weightage is same. History again you have to put effort. So as an aspirant, you need to understand that every part of syllabus is important. But I need to reach my cutoff. What is the cutoff? Cutoff क्या है? Cutoff is prelims cutoff. Sorry, this is prelims. Sorry, mains. No, this is prelims cutoff. Sorry, this is mains. Actually, it's prelims. 98, 105, 116. Which means cutoff is between 50-55%. That's all. Okay. You have to reach this cutoff range. And if I do two subjects properly, I can reach the cutoff. Ashutosh, questions main end mein lunga. I'll take questions in the end. Keep all your questions ready because I would request you to cover, make sure that, the pace is there. Ek baar main questions mein aapke end mein lunga. So first is understanding the syllabi. The prelims main start with the main syllabus and then understand the weightage of the subjects in every year. And that is how we do that. Now, and again, many times students ask me that, sir, this year geography was tough. Agriculture was tough. What will be tough next year? I don't have an answer. Last year, some areas were typical. This year, some other area were typical. Next year, some other area will be typical. But as a student, you have to cover all the subject. I'm not saying that skip that subject. Aap koi subject skip mat karo. But prioritize the subject based on the relevance of that subject in the examination based on past 10 years trend. A past 10 years trend ke basis pe, past 10 years trend ke basis pe, you develop your, basic, study plan. Ultimately, I have to read all the subjects because UPSC follows law of averages. Humko average har jagah score karna hai if I want to get selected. So I have to score, my target as a student, my target should be 60% so that I can easily above the cutoff. Cutoff se main 10% above hun. That should be my target. Okay, so you can see the cutoffs. And remember, getting the cutoff of 50% is not easy. As I mentioned, prelims is the toughest part of the examination and it will take most of your time and energy. Aapka prelims nikalna, sabse tough hota hai. Problem only is that many a time student prelims nikal lete, but the mains is not ready. Okay, so your objective is not only to read the prelims or study the prelims, but also focus on the main syllabi, because if you don't follow the main syllabi, the things will not work for you. So let's go ahead further. This is the main syllabus. Mains cutoff. Okay, this is all out of 750. In mains, we have 4 GS papers, 1 essay, and 2 options. So you can see the cutoffs. Again, these cutoffs will vary depending on, the scoring pattern can vary. For example, you can see the cutoff was 676. Next year, the cutoff was increased by 100 marks because there was a liberal marking here. Okay, so it depends how you, prepare for the examination. Objective of all the aspirants should be that you understand the, prelims as well as the mains approach. There's a final selection. You can see in less than 50%, you can get selected, and above 50%, you can get top rank. 50% means top ranks in India. Top ranks means up, within 200. 50-53%, which means practically you will get, top, 20-30 rank. Okay. So if you see the selection, UPSC is not a high scoring examination. It's a low scoring examination. Now let's understand in syllabus, there are 2 areas. First is the conventional area, which we call as static. Static means they will remain same. They never change. Then we have dynamic areas. Now, what are static areas? Static areas, history, they're static. History, modern history will not change. Ancient history will not change. Culture will not change. So this is a static area. It will not change. Indian constitution, quality. It will static area. It would not change. What is Article 74? What is Article 18, 19? This will not change. Because you might get question this year also or 2 years also, later also. Basis of economics. What is inflation? What is, you know, Bessel norms? So these are basic concepts which are there. So it's a part of economy. Similarly, geography, general science, environment, ecology, climate change. So these are static areas. In static areas, the best way to start with the NCRTs of that particular subject. After covering the NCRT, you just need to follow one standard book. Again, I'll reiterate and repeat. You just have to follow one standard book. Remember, UPSC believes or works in the law of averages. At the same time, UPSC, you know, you don't have to read, you know, 10 books for the same subjects. You read one book for one subject and be so thorough in that book that you're able to, you know, overcome all the challenges. So I was always advise that stick to the NCRTs and one standard book in these areas. I'll share the book list. Book list is there in the end. This PPT, you know, is in the PDF form, will be shared with you later on. Then comes the unconventional areas, as I mentioned. These are dynamic areas. So in dynamic areas, you have daily newspapers, topics like governance, okay, application of quality. Social issues, education, health, women and child development, you know, old care, you know, SCST, welfare programs, tribal issues, social issues. Then science and tech, again, current issues. You have 5G technology in news. You have, you know, big data. We have automation. We have machine learning. Okay, so all these are current, you know, topics which are in news. You have recently, you know, vaccine, a virus. Okay. What is virus? What is bacteria? What is protozoa? So science and tech, current issues. In social issues, as I mentioned, education, health, women and child development, you know, old age care. Okay. So all these could be the areas in the social issues, and you have to be thorough. But they are entirely dependent on the current issues. Social issues means education, health, these are social issues. They come in social issues. Then environment and climate change. Anything, for example, Paris climate action. Okay, National Solar Mission. Air quality index, stubble burning, abhi news mein tha. Okay. IR, very important part, what is happening in international relations right now? RCEP was in news recently last week. Okay. Similarly, G20 is always in news. Similarly, you know, WHO right now, was, you know, in few months, what is in news? UN is in news, IMF is in news. Okay. So these are related with international relations, current topic. All these. Basically, you have to focus current affair. Aapko current affair bahut acche se cover karna hoga. And current affair is the key. And here I would suggest that you read newspapers regularly and you follow some parallel sources, supportive sources like monthly magazines or daily current affair notes like that. Geography map based, very important. So these are dynamic areas, and these dynamic areas have to be covered on daily basis. Now, many a time what students make a mistake that they just read the newspaper. They don't analyze that what is important in the newspaper. They don't analyze ki whatever I'm reading, can it help me to crack the prelims question or not? And for that, after a month or so, jaise maan lo, you read Indian polity. In polity, you read about Indian parliament. Moment you read Indian parliament, you feel comfortable. You feel happy. Oh, okay, I understand Indian parliament. But your quest should not end here. You should go next level. Aap next level pe jao. Go follow the previous year question, past 10 years. 20 years, 10, 15 years. Also see the questions in mains that have come. Can you clear those questions? Can you solve those questions? what is your comfort level? And based on those questions, as your questions ko dekhoge, you'll understand, you'll develop a filter. So it is not that you just cover the dynamic areas, your work is done. That is the beginning. You cover the nodes on daily basis, but always go and do backward linkage. Backward linkage. I'm not saying that do on a daily basis, but maybe once in a while, in a week, in a subject, whatever. Aapne, let's say you covered polity last 1 week, the topics that you've covered, at least go through and see the questions that have come. Try to ask yourself, am I comfortable in these areas? Can I crack this question tomorrow when it comes in prelims or mains? Do I have an understanding of this issue or not? Do I have an understanding where I can crack the toughness level of UPSC examination? So many a time students sirf padhte hain, they don't go beyond that. Reading is one part. I'm asking about application of what you're reading on day-to-day basis, because that will bring result. That is the ultimate thing. You do this for 6 months, 8 months, believe me, you'll find yourself good job in the, you know, state government or the central government. But here, student make a mistake. They, you know, they don't make an effort on daily basis. This will require maybe just 10, 15 minutes of daily effort. Maybe once in a week, let's say you've covered economy, two topics, at least go and see the questions that have come in the previous year. So that is what is needed. Dynamic area is not only limited up to just reading the newspaper and covering the current issues. It is also about mapping what has come in the previous year, understanding that if a question comes in this topic, kya ye niklega mere se, then also you have to solve the previous year questions also if possible. For example, right now we have a mentoring program, mains mentoring program. In that mentoring program, you know, we give students every questions every week. They attempt. Then we have a weekly mentoring session where we, you know, tell, okay, aapne answer aisa likha, isme, this is the gap, this X gap in your answer, this Y gap in your answer. So maybe that will help you in understanding and filtering the dynamic area. So as an aspirant, you need to always, you know, not only study, but always, you know, evaluate, reassess how preparation is going. Not on a daily basis, but at least, you know, maybe every fortnight, har 15 din pe assess karo ki mera preparation track pe ja raha hai ya nahi ja raha. At least reach out to a mentor, ask the mentor. Okay. So this is the static area and this is the dynamic area. Okay. And if you focus, you know, on the dynamic areas in parallel with the static areas, so things will work for you. Remember the day. This is the day we are targeting at. Let's make this day one of the most important day of my life. The day you get selected, believe me, student who gets selected, if you ask, jab jo student select ho jaate hain, unse poocho that, you know, do you remember the date of prelims? Do you remember the date of mains? Believe me, they remember each and every word. They remember each and every word. So we have to reach to that level. The date should become, it's like this is one of the most important date of my life. So right now, if I say we have 7 months, if I say 1 month ko aap warm up karte ho, if you start from scratch, one month aap warm up karte ho, you know, in focusing basic NCRTs, the next, you know, understanding, you know, filtering apna UPSC ka newspaper kaise padhna hai, how do you read newspapers, you develop your filtering system. Okay, so next month, if you do that, maybe in the last 6 months, you have to crack the examination. I expect, you know, on an average 8 hours, effective 8 hours, quality 8 hours on day-to-day basis. I follow 1/3 rule. So 1/3 of your every day is what we expect. And if you do not have a job, if you're a full-time person, you follow this approach and things will work for you very effectively. Okay, so that is the ultimate objective, you know, which students should have. Now, students ask me, sir, what should I do in the prelims 2021? When I already discussed kiya that in the newspaper part, you have to filter. So for static areas, how do we do that? Static areas, first, make an important book list. All subjects, economy, polity, history, geography, culture, environment. For example, in Lakshmi, in polity, we have Lakshmikant. In economy, we might have Mishra and Puri. Or Datta Sundaram, or, Verma. In environment, you might have, NIS notes. Okay. In history, you might have NCRTs. plus spectrum. In geography, you might have NCRTs plus GC Leong. So make a list of books. And remember, these books, book list should be your, like, you know, God for the next few months. They should be your best friend. And you have to be very thorough in these. Then you follow the main syllabus. Always follow the main syllabus. Stick every word, syllabus, each point in syllabus. Ask yourself that this topic is covered in the book, standard book. And I, you know, and am I, you know, following this, you know, in the, my book or not? Similarly, always, when you do that, you know, mark it in the syllabus, this part is covered, this part is covered, this part is left, this part is covered, step by step. Okay. Remember, Rome was not built in a day. It took a lot of time. Similarly, preparation is a long journey. I'm talking about next seven and a half months. Okay. Once you read that, let's say you have covered in polity or in economy. Let's say in economy, you covered national income. You covered inflation. Okay, you covered banking. Once these topics are over, okay, now you feel comfortable. Map the starting area of the previous year question. Last 10 years, 2011 onwards. Solve all the questions of national income in past 10 years. Solve all the questions on inflation of last 10 years. Banking mein last 10 years mein kaun se sawal aaye hain? Try to solve them. Okay, so that is the next approach. Remember, it should go parallel. Student, what student make a mistake? They don't follow the approach. They just, you know, just read it. Okay. Then after that, parallel, you know, for example, if you're a student of ISH, we provide you module test, topic wise test, you know, sectional test, test series, attempt MCQs. If you're not a part of any course at some coaching institute, you know, at least follow previous year questions. Okay. The same should apply in mains as well. Same. For prelims, the same strategy should be mains as well. And that should be the remember. In mains is not only about studying. Study is the first thing. The second part of the study is about answer writing. So I would always advise you to at least write, you know, 5 to 10 or 8 to 10 answers every week. Every alternate day, you can write answers. Just do answer likho. Half an hour invest in that. So these are very important part for the static areas. Once your static areas are covered, you develop understanding of dynamic area. For example, banking ka topic hai. Once you cover the static of banking, the dynamic will be able, you will be able to understand. So that is why I always advise you to follow the static areas in parallel with the dynamic area. Okay. Many a times you might get a concept which is dynamic and you have not understood the concept in the static area. So that will face, that you might face problem. Okay. So that is the static area. Then the dynamic area, current affairs, 15, 18 months, personal notes, monthly magazine, make a list of topics which are important. Because when you're following previous year question papers, you can filter, okay, this topic, okay, banking, this topic looks important. Make a list, okay, banking important topic. Okay, previous year question, you're doing that, you'll be able to filter that. You know, because ultimately questions, UPSC will not ask questions randomly. They're going to ask questions which are relevant, which are there in the news. Apply it section wise, okay? Quality, economy. If you don't have time right now, abhi mat karo. You can do this probably 3 months late down the line. Abhi mat karo. You can do that. Right now, focus on, you know, filtering the current affair part, the dynamic part, that is more important. Then application should be subject wise. Economics. Maybe after 3 months, your economics is ready. Make a list of topics which are in news right now. COVID-19, man, you know, government of India RBI used a lot of new tools in monetary policy. Okay, understand that. Okay. Similarly, maybe, you know, you will see that the questions, there is a certain pattern in the prelims. The pattern of questions that I asked, the topics that I asked. Maybe question will not repeat, but the concept will repeat. Okay. So you need to, you know, make a, you know, list of such that. Maybe understand them. And for that, remember, not only studying, apart from studying, you always have to, you know, analyze what is coming. Okay, agriculture. Okay, I've read agriculture. Okay, agriculture is a case of agriculture. These kind of questions come from agriculture. You know, government schemes, policy initiatives, okay, new education policy. Okay, so you need to understand all that. Okay, so after reading the subject, I always, I'm a believer of application of concept. I believe that the best suggestion would be that you focus on developing your understanding where you can crack the examination. Okay, Vikrant, I'll share the PDF. Don't worry, the PDF will be shared with you. You can read it n number of times. The same should be true for geography. For example, geography maps are very important. Maps are linked with the current issues. They are linked with the international event. So this G20 summit is happening somewhere. Okay, locate on the map. Wuhan is in news. You must have read Wuhan Corona. You know virus started there. But if I ask you, do you know where Wuhan is? Oh, it's in China. Where in China? Which part of China? Central China, Eastern China, Western China, Coastal China. So you need to know where Wuhan is. Look, I know when. So always, you know, have an atlas ready with you. Okay. Remember, hard work. Many people are doing hard work. It is not about hard work. Hard work is just one part of the operation. You have to apply the hard work in requirement of the competition. Okay. Similarly, conferences and summits. If there is a news, discoveries, disasters. There's some disaster happening. Recently, a cyclone, you know, was in news yesterday. Which part of the cyclone hit? How the cyclones are made? Okay. So that is where it is important. So whenever you study, you know, the preparation, you always need to understand that preparation ko aapko apply karna padega in the examination part. Then flora and fauna. Jaise maan lo geography mein flora, great Indian bustard in news. So great, this is the great Indian bustard, a very famous bird. The population is declined by 90%. It is there in news all the time. Which national park it is found, which wildlife sanctuary it is found. You'd be surprised to know in the past 10 years, 3 to 4 questions have come in the great Indian bustard. What do? You don't follow that. You follow some coaching note. You follow some, you know, some book which is there in the market. You know, you are not following the news. You're not following what is important. Okay. So where it is found. This year also in prelims, the great Indian bustard was there. I remember when I was preparing, great Indian bustard was in news. Okay. You know, which vegetation is important, some national park is important, some in some part there's a man animal conflict kahin hua hoga, some accident has happened in some, you know, national park. Okay, which are the rivers passing through them? So where are minute observations are also important, because they will help you in cracking the questions that you know. UPSC will never ask questions randomly. Questions have to have some kind of link with that. A smart student will find its way out from that. And remember, newspaper reading is the crux, but it is also about how well you're able to use a newspaper for your, you know, preparation. Then quality and governance, very important part of. In fact, in mains, more than 150 marks come from quality and governance. Okay, rights issues, philosophical, every time there is a news, some kind of news is there. Okay, some policies there, bills are there, the process, the technical part is also, you know, many times important. So we need to, you know, aapko quality and governance ya kisi bhi subject mein aapko dekhna padega ki wahan kaise question aate hain prelims and mains mein, and you have to map with the current. Then recently, you say, you know, Ram Mandir was in news. It is based on the Nagara, you know, architecture. Okay, so even it is a part of static area, but it was in news. Okay, so this is you know, Nagara. This is, it's like a chariot like structure is there. Okay, there's Shikara is there. Then there is some, you know, great hall is there, Mahamandap, then there's a small hall, Mandap is there. So, you know, you need to understand that. So whenever you study preparation, you always have to look for the kind of questions that might be asked from that. Okay. In science and tech, you have to focus on dynamic areas, make an important list of topics, be thorough here. Again, ye jo science and tech, ye jo dynamic area, this should start after March, not today. But at least in the next 3 months, you should focus on covering your basics. Now study time. Let's stick to the study time. So you have 180 days. If I say first 3 months, cover the basics, cover the standard books, cover the static areas. Okay. You can follow, you can give some time for revision also, maybe 10, 15, 20% time for revision. Cover the standard book till March. March the koish karo ki sara standard book cover ho jaye. Still we have 4 months from now. And the last 3 months, April, May, till mid-June. test and revision, test and revision. Okay, don't you know, plan your preparation right now. Don't plan something for the end. Last 2 months ke liye planning kam rakho. Okay, make sure you most of the part is covered now. So 180 days for for prelims as well as mains. Last 3 months should be entirely for prelims. Last 3 months for prelims. Abhi ka jo 4 months hai, you can focus on mains plus prelims plus mains. But right now, focus should be on at least covering the standard books in all the subjects. Now study schedule. Now you need to have, remember many times student ask me, sir, what should be my study plan? How should I start my preparation? Always remember, you should have at least a weekly study plan. Don't make daily study plan. Don't every day get up in the morning and okay, what I'll study, I'll make. No, make a weekly plan. The reason why I'm telling you that on daily basis, many a times one day is good for you, other day might be bad for you. So many a times you might not be able to meet your target. Agar aap daily plan banate ho, targets meet karna mushkil hota hai. So always have a weekly target, weekly study plan plus weekly target. Okay. Then start with subjects like economics, polity, history, geography. Always, because why? Because these are static subjects and they have high relevance. When you cover these subjects, you're practically covering 70-80% of the syllabus. Okay. Many times students ask me when to start CSAT, very important, but start in Jan, Feb, maybe end of Jan, first week of Feb, you can start. Abhi ke liye aap CSAT ko side mein kar do. Okay. And minimum 7 to 8 hours of study schedule should be. As I mentioned, start with weekly schedule. And when you start your weekly schedule, ek basic target banao and try and understand how my preparation is moving. Newspaper reading is must. Make small and realistic target. Okay. Abhi kya hai? What should my target? You don't know your target. Many times you make a plan, you don't understand the target. So that is something which also needs to be understood. Remember, parallelly, remember, you know that UPSC is not a step-by-step process. UPSC, you have to do many things in parallel. आपको क्वेश्चन भी देखना होगा, यू हैव टू अटेम्प्ट आंसर राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस आल्सो, यू हैव टू कवर स्टैटिक टॉपिक आल्सो, यू हैव टू कवर डायनेमिक टॉपिक आल्सो. यू कैन डिवाइड योर डे फॉर स्टैटिक सब स्टैटिक एरियाज एंड डायनेमिक एरियाज. आप मॉर्निंग में स्टैटिक पढ़ो या मॉर्निंग में डायनेमिक पढ़ो, इवनिंग में स्टैटिक पढ़ो, डिवाइड कर सकते हो. यू कैन डिवाइड योर टाइम. ओके, प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन पेपर्स, मॉक टेस्ट, दे विल आल्सो बिकम पार्ट ऑफ प्रिपरेशन, मे बी अ मंथ डाउन द लाइन. Student always ask me that which question should be followed previous year for prelims 2010 or 2011 onwards, for mains 2013 onwards. Aap prelims ka 10 ya 11 onwards follow karo, last 10 years. And in prelims, last 4-5 years is very important. Why? Because they give the trend in the recent time. Abhi aap 11-12 ka paper dekh rahe ho, you might find it easy. But the trend for last 4 years is very important. Because paper can be tough, it can be easy. If paper is tough, the cutoff will be low. If paper is easy, cutoff will be high. So don't get happy if you get, you know, okay, this paper I'm missing, nikal raha, okay, good. But try to see the cutoff also. So that is how you should be there. So mock test and solving previous year question paper, this is also very important part. Student kya hai na, hum log ka ek habit hota hai, and our habit is hum aur padhte hain, let's focus and read more. And that is something that needs to be improved. Now, general test of preparation. Remember, UPSC is not a sprint. You're not following a sprint. It is a marathon. Consistent, regular, slowly, every day, effort is important. Okay. Consistent, persevered effort. Divide your day for static and dynamic areas. Divide your day. Current affair and newspaper reading. Very important, very crucial. Don't miss it. After in just 2 weeks from now, I'll be starting daily current affair analysis. DNA mein alag se online start karne wala hun, which will be YouTube live every day. So I'm planning daily newspaper analysis. So newspaper editorials part. Okay, so my team is working on that, and then I'll be taking these sessions on 5 days a week. Very important part. So I'll be at least listing you important part on daily basis. Okay, follow one standard book in every subject. Choose your optional. Optionally padhna padega. Optional aisa nahi ki you can't decide optional after prelims. You don't have time. decided the option right now. Shortcuts. I'm not telling you any shortcuts. I'm just following you a basic standard approach. Follow the basic process. Always have a mentor, somebody you can look up to, somebody you can ask doubts your question. Don't always, you know, you might do self-study, but at least have somebody who can actually help you ki kya work kar raha hai, kya nahi work kar raha hai. Okay? Take inputs in terms of feedback. I'm not saying that join some coaching with a lot of fee. At least look for some mentor, you know, who can help you. At least, you know, maybe track your preparation, you know, maybe once in a while, maybe every 15 days in a week. At least somebody you can speak to for half an hour or 15 minutes. And remember, this mentor should be somebody who has an experience of CSE process. Jisko UPSC ka CSE process ka experience hoga. Somebody who has at least given mains or interview. Okay, so they can help you. Interview rahe to best hai. Somebody interview tak diya hai to best hai. Okay. And also take care of health. Very important. Regular and consistent routine is needed. Vikrant has a question. Vikrant, I'll take question in the end, beta. Question mein end milunga. Just in 5 minutes, I'll be taking questions. Again, diet and physical activity, very important. Very important. Diet. Take care of health next 7 months, 8 months. Balanced diet is needed. Small meals. Take rest also. Physical activity, small breaks. Your study schedule should be at least 6 days a week. You can take a break for half day. You need to develop a habit. Okay. I always believe in making a habit. Developing a habit is very good for night preparation. These are some NCERT books. You can refer them later on. What are the courses at ISH quickly? We are having right now online live course, pre-plus mains, 1 year, 2 year, 3 year. We have a GS mentoring course for students who want guidance for next year. This will be one session a week. Plus, you know, interaction call with faculty, mentor, you know, you can speak to a mentor. We have PSIR optional, which is right now going on. And we have GS mains mentoring program, people who want to prepare only for mains answer writing, it is for them. These are the courses that we have at ISH. Okay. So that is all for today.